wearing PPE for more than 8 to 12 hours without going to washroom.
I had that first that mental war with my cell phone.
I think in the past three and a half months, I haven't had a meal with my parents or my family.
Yes, I was stressed right from the point when I got my swab positive.
As India navigates its way through COVID-19, our healthcare workers are at the front line, fighting a tough battle against an invisible enemy. With increasing patient load, these medical workers are putting in long hours, wearing uncomfortable personal protective equipment away from their family for days. The probe got in touch with a team of doctors, intensivists in Mumbai, which is one of the worst affected cities in the world, to understand the direct consequence of the pandemic on their mental health. Dr. Sandeep Gore is leading a team of 12 doctors and 22 nurses, providing COVID assistance at Mumbai's Fortis Hospital.
This is my team, and when I remove the mask, they look like this.
Ever since the pandemic, Sandeep and his team members have been working hard to ensure that no patient is turned away. The doctors here say they're literally bathing in COVID, and their lives have changed forever.
We are bathing in COVID because so many patients are there.
In 8 to 9 hours, we are in PPE and in N95. And we can't remove the N95 in between. We have to be without water, without food, anything. And we are doing this duty continuously.
Mentally, psychologically, everything's changed. You know, it's a different picture now.
As cases continue to rise, so has the strain on these health workers. Overworked, underprotected, the pandemic is also taking a toll on the mental health of these frontline warriors.
Definitely, each and every of my colleagues who is working in COVID, okay, we had a mental stress. Definitely, we had mental stress.
Actually, the biggest fear of mine was like, I should not infect my parents and family members.
Dr. Sushil Shinde, who's a gynecologist, has paid the price for being a COVID warrior. He contracted coronavirus while on duty. For the first time, he says, he was on the other side of the bed, and this was life-changing for him.
I did my test in Fortis, and then it was positive. And I was admitted in the ICU, and that was really a scene-changing for me, that I've never been to an ICU for any other as such in a patient. I was never admitted for the whole life at present. But then directly going into the ward, getting admitted, and then going to ICU was really a shocking thing for me because it changed my life.
Not many doctors have been as lucky as Dr. Shinde. Hundreds of lives of healthcare workers have been lost in India due to the virus. Sadly, the government doesn't have any data on this. The Indian Medical Association has, however, put out a list stating that over 500 doctors have died due to the pandemic. But the doctors we spoke to say these figures are just the tip of the iceberg, and these concerns have greatly impacted their mental health.
So number one is recognize that this is an issue, a really substantive issue that needs greater attention. I think second is allowing space for the health professionals to actually talk about this, verbalize it, have place between themselves, have counseling available, have people who they can talk to, trained professionals.
I fully agree that some kind of counseling support should be there. They can have telephone lines for doctors to seek help and have telephone counseling. They must use technology in today's times.
When the coronavirus outbreak was at its peak in Italy, the government there launched a nationwide psychological support campaign for its healthcare workers. But sadly, in India, the apathy continues.
But I think the underlying philosophy should be one of empathy and recognizing the better you provide support to your health professionals, the better they're going to provide support to their patients.
It's not just governmental apathy. Violence, discrimination, neglect. These doctors say they are shunned by the very own society they intend to serve.
My barber, he generally cuts hair, and all the people around normally with a mask on, when I go in and he quickly wears a PPE, and you know, that is like discrimination kind of thing. But it's there, it's okay, I don't mind. Actually, I am seeing COVID patients, and yes, I am a potent source of infection for the society. So it is okay for them to panic in front of me. But you know, I'm not an untouchable. I'm just a part of the society that we're living in. And I'm trying for the betterment of this society.
Undoubtedly, the COVID-19 crisis has led to a rise in anxiety levels amongst the doctors and paramedics. But this has not deterred them from their determination to serve.
Once a doctor, you're always a doctor. So you can't escape from it. You have to face it. If I don't do anything, the others are going to suffer.
We will keep fighting this disease till it is eradicated. You know, so we've were held up for this long, for 5-6 months, we'll hold up more longer. We'll hold our fortress.